Last December, my daughter was rushed to the emergency room for intensive stomach pain. She was admitted to the hospital locally in our town and then was transferred to a children's hospital immediately that evening. And the next morning was in emergency surgery, which was life-changing for me because I wasn't notified of this happening.
Around 6 in the morning, the doctors came in and said, we're gonna have to take her in for emergency surgery. I contacted Leanne and said, going down for surgery. She did not contact me until she was already in recovery. Rather than saying, oh my gosh, I'll be right there, she started ranting and raving about how I had no right to allow this surgery to happen without her permission. I couldn't reach her. I did what I had to do for my granddaughter, and her feelings were not my priority.
She was completely out of line.
Okay, she says you were completely out of line, but you have full custody of these children, right?
Yes.
She has no parental rights at this point. You make medical decisions, educational decisions. You make all the decisions for these children because you have full custody.
Complete custody.
And part of the reason you do is because of her failure to step up as a mother. And one of the examples of that is these children being dropped off by people that were strangers to you, at least. She put your address on a Post-it note.
Well, this was at the end of the weekend.
But they showed up at your house.
She disappeared Friday morning. She was high that day. They were gone all weekend, and sometime around 11 o'clock on Sunday night, we get a knock at the door, and it's this young couple. I said, who are you? Why do you have my grandchildren? They showed me a little yellow sticky that had my address on it and said, someone just told us to bring these kids here. Leanne wasn't with them. We didn't even find out where she was till the next day.
Which was where?
This person who had picked her up on Friday morning realized there was something horribly wrong with her and put her on an ambulance and sent the kids, thank God, didn't leave them on the side of the road somewhere, but sent the kids home.
Now, there's a pattern here. Does she show up for holidays?
Not this year. None of
she didn't show up for Christmas.
She did not show up for Christmas.
Thanksgiving, did she show up?
Thanksgiving, no.
What's more important than being with your children on Thanksgiving or Christmas?
There's nothing that's more important.
Apparently there is, because you weren't there.
Right, and
what was more important than being there?
There was nothing more important. I was without a car. It was circumstances that every time that I go back into the home, she makes it very clear, get out, get out, get out. And all the conflict happens in front of the children. And I understand that based off the evidence that she is presenting today, it appears as though it's just it's some denial form. But what she's stating dates back about 5 years ago, at least 5 years ago.
Well, here's the text from your son. And this was last year. This isn't 5 years ago. This was last Christmas.
Correct. I'm stuck
December
with no
24th, 2017. Mm-hmm. Leanne, 3:10 p.m. Mm-hmm. Hi, son. Hey, Leanne. I'm stuck with no car, trying to figure out so I can visit you, son. Sure, you are a liar. Leanne, it hasn't been running for about a week now. Don't speak to me like that. I have no reason to lie to you. I want nothing more than to be with you and your sister. Son, 4:25 p.m., are you coming over? Leanne, not able to without her making it difficult to enjoy time with you. I'm sorry, but going to court soon. This is our last year suffering like this. Son, when are you going to court? Leanne, don't worry about that, babe. I'll keep you updated on everything that occurs. You don't need to be subjected to all this conflict. You're a child, and I'm going to protect you, son, period.
And that's why I'm here today. You know, the evidence, I understand, appears as though it's very deceptive and very deceiving. I admit that I have faults. I admit that I've done very wrong in the past. I've made bad choices. I have a history of substance abuse. But these allegations that she's making, I have since proven to no longer be true.